Hey everyone, this is 2Cubes, and today we're going to take a look at the WebForm system, specifically to see how the different WebForms are carried in the player, how he drowns, skip, or move with the WebForms, and the movements made when he manages or carries a WebForm. So, for example, in this case, we can see that he makes a smooth draw of the WebForm. When he moves, this one is carried in a fixed plate in his body. If we change to the next weapon, we can see that he makes also a smooth draw of the weapon, but when he moves, the weapon is placed in a different zone of his body. With this weapon, you can see that he takes it smoothly, but when he moves, no inversive kinematics are used in this case, so the weapon is placed directly in the hands of the player. But when he aims the weapon, he makes the movement properly. In the next case, you can see how the weapon is placed directly in the player's hand, but also like the previous one, the weapon doesn't use inversive kinematics. So instead of that, the player carries the weapon in his hand. And in the last case, here also the player draws the weapon quickly, but after that, the weapon is carried in a fixed plate, like in other weapons. I mean, I'm fighting the weapon. So let's see how this works. For that, we are going to go for the player controlling an object, and here we are going to go to player weapons manager and show settings. Here we have the option which is disabled by default, called use kick draw weapon, and this option what this option makes is place the each weapon directly in the hands of the player when he draws the weapon, or change between them. So we can see how this works. So let's press the draw weapon button, and as you can see, the weapon is placed directly in the player's hands without any smooth movement of the player's hands. And of course, he can carry the weapons as normally, with the only difference that the weapon is placed directly in his hand when he changes it. For now, let's disable this option in order to show the rest of the options for each weapon, which in this case, each weapon has options to carry and draw the weapon itself separately in each one. Let's show the weapon list, which can be found in the same inspector. And this is the current list of weapons that the player can use during the game. And we are going to select this one here in show element settings, show third person, and show single weapons. This is the separated settings for dual and single weapon. We're going to check in this case the single options. And here we have different options. For example, at the bottom of the inspector, we have the use kick draw weapon, use kick draw and keep weapon. And in this case, is a similar option to the general one that we have seen, but in this case, it's going to only work for this weapon, which is the P35. In this case, maybe it's not easy to notice, but the weapon is placed directly in the hands of the player before make the movement. We can actually try this setting in another weapon. For example, in the assault rifle, So we go here and in the say option, which is this one, and try that. So you can see how this time he doesn't make the movement of the weapon, but the weapon is placed directly in his hand. And we can see that once he makes the movement, the weapon is placed directly in his back again. And here you can see the same weapon, but with the option to use the kick draw disabled. So you can see how the player makes the draw and keep a smooth movement. You may be asked yourself, when this use kick draw weapon option is useful? Well, it is useful when the weapon to draw is maybe too far away from the hands of the player to reach it and move it properly without looking outward. Like in this case, we can see that the shotgun and the other rifle are in a, you can see here on his back, that the positions are a little far away than usual. So in this case it's useful that first the weapon is placed directly on the hands of the player. For example, in the shotgun, it has the option to use inverse kinematics active, so the weapon is placed there. And as you can see, when he moves, the weapon is still there. And the other weapon is placed on his hands, but it doesn't use inverse kinematics. So he carries the weapon on his hand in every moment. Another setting that can be used is the when the player moves carrying the weapon, but not aiming it, you can see that sometimes he places the weapon in a different place when he moves and put it back in a different place when he stops to walk. And we can show this that option again. This is the option, and you can see here how when he starts to move, the weapon is placed in a different zone of the player, and same when he stops to move. So that option can be disabled in here in the same spectrum as before in IK weapon system. Here in use run position, if we disable this, when the player moves, he will keep the weapon in the same position as before. And let's show how that works. So we move now, but the weapon remains in the same position. In the case of the use run position option, you can see here how a transform is configured in this field. And this is the position or the reference position. Use it to configure where the weapon is placed when the player moves. So in this case it's this one, and you can configure it to place it as you need. For example, that position, and you can see that here. That looks strange, but this is the wood of the system. You can customize the position as you prefer. For example, let's see. That is worse, but you get the point. You can customize this as you want, but the different positions of the waffles where the player plays the waffle in each situation is going to be checked in another video. And for the last option, we are going to see the one which manages if the inverse kinematics is used or not when the weapon carries a weapon. Like for example, in this case, this weapon is using inverse kinematics when the the player is carrying it. And for example, this one is placed directly in the hands of the weapon of the player without inverse kinematics activated. For example, this one uses it. This one, no. So let's take a look at that. So here in the weapon settings, as before, we have here the activated IK if no aiming settings. So this first option, if we set as true, this is the one which manages this this option to use it or not use the inverse kinematic. IK is the letters for inverse kinematics. So now this weapon, the P35, has this option disabled. So let's see how it looks now. And you can see how once he draws the weapon, he doesn't use his other hand to grab the weapon, and he just carries in his hand. We can try this setting too in the rifle. And you can see this makes the draw movement of the weapon. But one that is complete, he puts the weapon on his hand. So, as you have seen, there are many options for the weapon, and you can configure it as you need, and all the previous options can be combined as you prefer. So, as you have seen in the first part of the video, these current weapons are configured with different settings, like the use of inverse kinematics or a quick draw of the weapon, or use of no a different movement place when the player moves, like in this case. So many options to use. So this is all for today. Have a nice day and take care. Bye.